lecture number 3 and subject is your favorite English. As we all of are knowing that we are having the chapter number 1 that is the best Christmas gift in the world. So we all are so much confused and curious to know that which gift can be the best in the Christmas festival, and that too we have to compare the all gift of the whole world. Now today we are going to have the story which was narrated by Jim McPherson. Right, as earlier I have told you that this chapter is divided into 3 parts. So first part is narrated by the writer, the author. Second part is narrated by Jim McPherson. It means Jim McPherson is an officer from English Army. It means Tommies. Now let's back to the points and we'll continue with the chapter. Till time we have seen that Jim McPherson, it means Tommies, and German Army, it means Fritz, they both were having World War I, right? Just now they both are enemy country. We are talking about 1914 whenever World War I was going on. Till we have seen that Jim McPherson saw white flag waving from the Fritz, they called out Happy Christmas loudly. Jim McPherson is telling to us, it means in the chapter he is telling to us, but in real situation he is writing a letter to his wife Connie McPherson, right, with the salutation Dearest Connie. He has written the letter to her. Now in this letter he is writing that first of all we should do the initiative, but with the strange, with our curiosity, the German have initiated, which with the white flag, and white flag is a symbol of peace. Tommy also wished the same cheerfully. So German army, right, from the German army one person came with a white flag. It means that you have to stop for a while. Right, in the battlefield, they both the army, the both the country, they were having fighting. One person is coming with white flag and he is telling that wait for a while. And loudly he just wished to all the Tommies, it means wished to the all English army, Happy Christmas. Now, the army, it means Tommies, English army also wished the same cheerfully. Because we know that all love festival. Who is not loving festival? I think not a single person on the earth is not liking festival, right? It's never happened. Whether it is in a battlefield or wherever, whatever the place will be, the person loves to celebrate. And this is the very famous festival. So Tommies also wish the same cheerfully. However, the air of confusion was offering them to share snacks and sausage. About 12 soldiers started coming towards no man's land. Now you will feel that what is meaning of snacks? And the spelling is too different and Mab is just pronouncing it as snacks. So the pronunciation is quite different, you have to remember that is sausage. This is one kind of a drink. Schnapps. Sausage. Sausage means it is one kind of a food item. Right? Now, obviously German and British, it means English army, they both men are having the similarities in food. They both are having similarities in drinks. So, as the German army offered them the schnapps and sausage, so obviously Tommies will also love to share the all things with them. So finally, the air of confusion was offering that it was confusing for both the officer from the German army and officer from the English army. But with the confusion, soldiers have started to share their schnapps and sausage. About 12 soldiers started to coming towards no man's land. So here we have the meaning of no man's land means, as I have told you, there is a particular space in between two countries' boundaries. That is called no man's land. Now, whenever two countries are fighting on a land, so that particular space, which is not belong to German, not belong to England, right? That place is called no man's land. Whenever any person, any soldier is at no man's land, no one can shoot him or her. That is no man's land, right? For example, just now only German and English army, they both are fighting. If any soldier from any side of a country, they are just standing in no man's land, opposite means enemy country cannot shoot them. Now, from the German army, about 12 soldiers started coming towards no man's land. So who is taking initiative? German army. Right, German army, they are taking initiative to celebrate the Christmas festival in the battlefield. Jim was rather happy that they were celebrating happiness with enemy soldier. These kind of a happiness, these kind of incidents, rare to happen and rare to see. Have ever we seen any kind of these incidents? I must say, we can say never, never, never. That two enemy countries, they are celebrating one festival during the World War in the battlefield, it is rare to happen. So this is very important incidents. And what Jim McPherson want to share with Connie McPherson, it means his wife. Right, that this is the best Christmas gift for us. Right, and we can say that from the world, in the world, this is the best Christmas gift. Now coming back to that, that Jim, it means officer from Tommy's, officer from English Army. Jim was rather happy that they were celebrating happiness with enemy soldiers. So this is, as I have told, it is the rare than rare to happen things. Now, let me introduce the third character of the chapter. First character, obviously, who? The narrator, the writer of the chapter, Michael Morpurgo. Second character in the part 2, we have, we know it, Jim McPherson, officer from the English Army. Now, whenever we are just going to introduce the third main character, that is Hans Wolf. Who is? That is Hans Wolf. Hans Wolf is the officer of German army. Right? It is the officer from German army. Head of officer, it means he is the commanding officer, we can say. So obviously German army came to the Tommies, to the English army, they have shared the sausage, they have shared the schnapps, and finally the officer is coming to Jim McPherson. Hans Wolf and Jim McPherson, the two officers of two armies, now they are introducing themselves. Yes students, so we were discussing about the introduction of Hans Wolf and Jim McPherson. So let's see the introduction of Hans Wolf, it means from the German army, and Jim McPherson, it means from the English army. Now, Hans Wolf has said in his introduction that he played the cello in the orchestra. Cello is the name of one instrument. So we know that all these soldiers, all the army men, before joining the army, at one place or another place or anything, they are doing, they are working with, and then they are selecting in the army as an army man, in the police force, in the soldiers. Now, Hans Wolf is saying that before he joined the army, he was the player, it means player of playing cello in the orchestra. He is from Düsseldorf. This is very important for us to remember the name of place from where he belonged to. So, he is from Düsseldorf. He is having a wife and Jim McPherson is from British Army. It means from the Thomas. Jim McPherson, it means he is a school teacher. Very important for us what he was, school teacher. Who was playing cello in the orchestra? Hans Wolf. Who is school teacher? Jim McPherson. He is from Dorset. He is from Dorset. Dorset is the name of place. Now, by the conversation, what they were doing, right? They have talked a lot. They have shared the rum and sausage. By the talking, by the conversation, Jim McPherson found that Hans Wolf is speaking perfect English. Perfect English. How it is possible that one person who has not set his foot in England ever and ever, and he is speaking perfect English in a perfect accent of English? It is not possible. But by the conversation, Hans Wolf has told that he knew the thing, it means the perfect English, from the school. Right, from the school, he learned each and everything of English. How to speak English, which are the accents of there. And second most important thing, he read a lot of books of English writer. Right, it means that whenever we will be having a habit of reading many and many books of English poet, English writers, then definitely we will have vocabulary. Right, we will have that much good sense of pronunciation and plus sense of words. What they are using, what is the meaning, how it is pronouncing, each and everything. So from the school, he learned the perfect English. He learned all about English from the school. From the school, he learned each and everything. Right, in this he has mentioned that who is his favorite author, who is his favorite poet. Right, which place is better and which books are, what we read, right, that each and everything they have been mentioned in that. Now let's come back to this. Whenever they were discussing each and everything, so Jim McPherson gave a Christmas gift which is made by Connie McPherson, and the name is Marzipan. Marzipan is a cake, Christmas cake, which is made, which is prepared, which is baked by Connie McPherson. Actually, that cake was for Jim McPherson. But as it was Christmas evening, as they both were conversing, right, they both are now looking so much friendly, right, whether they are belong to the enemy country. But just now, they both are sharing the information as of they are the friends since long time. So finally, Jim McPherson shared the Christmas cake that was marzipan. And Hans Wolf has accepted that I have never tasted this much the best cake. Right? So marzipan is the best cake in my life what I have tasted till time. The letter read as the narrator had best time with Elliot. So as in the earlier I have told you that this is the best time. Jim McPherson is saying that in my life, in my whole life, I have never seen these kind of time. I have never had these kind of time that with the enemy countries we are having. What we are having? We are having the best time with any countries. Next fun element was a football match. Right? They both were conversing. Now both, one German army, one British army, it means English army. They both are mixing together. Khaki coat and grey coat, they both are mixing together. And in that, one person took football. And he called that, let's play football. So we know that Germany is the best in the game of football. Whenever we are having Olympics and so many games, competition, we know that football competition won by Germany. And here the German people, it means German army, they have called to English army that let's play football. So Hans Wolf is also inviting Jim McPherson that let's play football. So Jim McPherson is saying that I'm not sure that who will win. Obviously, I'm having a lot of doubt that shall we win or not. Why? Because we are not best at football. That everyone is knowing. But Jim McPherson is putting comment that if the game was cricket, then I can give assurance that we only will win. Because we know that cricket was firstly played by the England. The people of England, right? So England, the people of England, they are best at cricket. But just now, in the ground, in the no man's land, the football game was going to play. Now, soldiers are soldiers, right? They are not considering that who will win and who will lose, whether playing football game or cricket. But they want to play the game, right? It is a very, then very good time that two enemy countries, soldiers are playing football. Now, who will win football? Germany or England people? It means which army? German, Tommies will win or Fritz will win? So that information we will see in the next lecture. Next lecture also is going to be interesting like this only. So we have to wait for the next session to